One of the topics that comes up most often in the LHON group is assistive technology. This year I've attended several conferences where a range of products were described and exhibited. My goal in this session is to expose you to some of the tools you might not yet know about, so you can look into them further to see if they might add value for you. This is just an overview of a few items. There's lots of tools out there I haven't included in this presentation. Hopefully during breaks, tonight, tomorrow, etc., everyone can share ideas, info, and tools you found helpful, what works for you, what doesn't, and how you obtained it cost effectively. One place to start is with the AFB, the American Foundation for the Blind. They have a site called Vision Aware, and it has lots of information that's helpful to individuals affected by LHON on a range of topics. One section of the site has a list of products and technology for living with vision loss. You can learn about tools to consider there, and a smartphone is often the first tool people rely on. Learning how to use your smartphone with LHON vision is important, and one resource is Hadley. Hadley offers free online learning at hadley.edu/instructional videos. They have about 90 free videos covering how to use the iPhone, as well as the Apple Watch, the iMac, and they have plans to bring more information about Apple TV, Nearby Explorer app, and more. I've also heard that a Bluetooth keyboard, or even placing several around the home, can make you more efficient with your smartphone. Andy Marks, where are you? Andy's in the back right, standing up, waving, and he is someone who advocates Bluetooth keyboards around the house, so feel free to ask him for more details. With a smartphone, there are many apps, and each individual finds those they prefer. I want to expose you to a few that came up frequently in a discussion of favorite apps that we had on the LHON Facebook group. When I asked about favorite apps, several folks indicated that their magnifier app, or magnifier with flashlight, is one of their most used apps. Some that were mentioned included Maglite, Over 40 magnifying glass with flashlight, Seeing Assistant magnifier, and the Samsung Galaxy magnifier widget. One of the most exciting new apps is a multi-purpose app called Seeing AI. It's offered by Microsoft. It's a versatile multi-purpose app that narrates the world around you and uses artificial intelligence to describe people, text, and objects. Here's an overview.
Seeing AI is a Microsoft research project for people with visual impairments. The app narrates the world around you by turning the visual world into an audible experience. Point your phone's camera, select a channel, and hear a description. The app recognizes saved friends.
Jenny near top right, 3 feet away.
Describes the people around you, including their emotions.
28-year-old female wearing glasses looking happy.
It reads text out loud as it comes into view, like on an envelope.
Ken Lawrence, P.O. Box.
Or a room entrance.
Conference 2005.
Or scan and read documents like books and letters. The app will guide you and recognize the text with its formatting.
Top and left edge is not visible. Hold steady. Lease agreement, disagreement.
When paying with cash, the app identifies currency bills.
$20.
When looking for something in your pantry or at the store, use the barcode scanner with audio cues to help you find what you want.
Campbell's tomato soup.
When available, hear additional product details.
Heat and microwave bowl on high.
And even hear descriptions of images in other apps like Twitter by importing them into Seeing AI.
A close-up of Bill Gates.
Finally, explore our experimental features, like scene descriptions, to get a glimpse of the future.
I think it's a young girl throwing a frisbee in the park.
Experience the world around you with the Seeing AI app from Microsoft.
There are also many apps that provide assistance with navigation and help you to be more aware of your surroundings. We had a speaker introduce the Blind Square app at our 2015 conference, and you can find that video on the LHON page at umdf.org. Here's an introduction to a couple of additional navigation apps recommended by some in the LHON community. The first is called Nearby Explorer. The second is Microsoft Soundscape.
Nearby Explorer is a GPS app that you can use to get from A to B and explore your surroundings audibly, including streets, transit schedules, and points of interest. Let's get moving.
Enable virtual navigate nearby position 6 meters north.
On 30
30 meters, turn right on Granville Street.
Like other apps, you can get turn-by-turn directions.
In 70 meters, turn left on Helmkin Street.
Hear streets and other reference points as you approach them, and spin the phone around in different directions to hear what's around you. But there are lots of features that make it unique.
1162, near Emery Barnes Park, 0 meters north.
You have the greatest control I've ever seen at setting what info you'd like to hear. Everything from your heading, approaching intersections, nearby transit stops, to info like the street address numbers on the block, your altitude, and your distance and direction from a reference point like your office.
Helmkin Street to hit 80 meters. Helmkin Street.
Another great feature is the ability to virtually explore your surroundings, just as though you were looking at a map, which sighted users find convenient. For me, it's much easier to listen to the info, and that's exactly what Nearby Explore provides. So from any location, I can virtually walk in any direction to hear whatever info I want, just as though I was really walking. I can even see how long the blocks are and in what direction the roads are headed.
In 130 meters, turn left on Davy Street.
No GPS app is perfect, but Nearby Explore has the polish and features of a commercial GPS unit. You can pick it up in the Google Play Store or the App Store.
Good boy, steady. Steady, good boy.
We want to explore our world in the same ways that everybody else wants to explore their world. Soundscape fills in a lot of the mental map as you move. It makes it effortless and seamless to know what's around you because it's designed such that you can just put it in your pocket and go.
DSW Shoe Warehouse.
DSW Shoe Warehouse? Cool things happening around town here.
When I'm with other people, I'm able to gather a lot of the same information my sighted friends or family are getting from the signage around me. And with that, I'm able to participate in, hey, look, what's over there?
Desigual.
Oh, Desigual is showing up here as well, which is one of my favorite stores.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Those moments that don't usually happen for me in my life.
It was great telling me all the different shops as I passed, which is lovely. And the different street names as well. Quite often I don't know, you know, which street's which.
Approaching intersection. Battery goes right.
We have a beacon set for Nike store, 248 yards.
The beacon has been helpful in approaching different addresses and places in busier areas.
I'm getting the bell right about here.
Great, so let's just head off that way.
Okay. Forward.
Reading is another function that apps can assist with. One highly regarded tool is the KNFB Reader that converts any text to speech instantly and accurately. Its base price is fairly expensive at $99.99, but it's often on sale. Sprint offers it free with a new line activation or eligible upgrade. NFB Newsline is a free service to the blind and vision impaired. Over 500 publications, including national and local newspapers, magazines, TV listings with audio description, etc., are updated as new issues are published. A lot of people affected by LHON read more books now than they did before they were affected, using audiobooks. Several apps turn your phone or tablet into a book using VoiceOver. Options include Audible, Bard, Kindle, Voice Aloud Reader, and Voice Dream Reader. Some are text-to-speech, some are narrated by a human. There are a range of smart devices that can be controlled via Bluetooth, instant pot smart cooker, meat thermometers, and more. Sometimes what you really need is another person to see what you can't and tell you about it. Be My Eyes is a free app that can make that happen. It connects those with a vision impairment to those who can see through a live video call. They also have a relationship with Microsoft and other customer service teams to connect folks who are vision impaired with customer service. You can download the Be My Eyes app and sign up as either a user or a volunteer.
Be My Eyes is an app that allows a blind or visually impaired individual to link up via video chat with a sighted volunteer who will have access to the camera on my device and they will be able to assist me or anyone who is blind or visually impaired with any task that I choose to have them help me with. And today I'm going to be asking them what type of granola bar this granola bar that I'm holding is. As soon as you open the app, you register as either a blind or a sighted person. I have the app open, and the first option is going to be to connect to the first available volunteer, which is what I want to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double tap on the button that will connect me to the first available helper, and at that point I will be placed into a queue, and I will wait for someone to accept the notification they receive to be my volunteer to assist me with my task. So I'm going to double tap right now.
Creating request summon.
And now it says creating request, and I'm being placed in a queue. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. I'm wondering if you could help me identify. I have a granola bar, and I'm not sure what kind of granola bar it is.
Okay.
Do you see it?
It is, yes. If you can move it down a little bit. It's a Nature Valley chewy, and it looks like chocolate. Can you move it to the right a little more?
Sure.
It's actually upside down, but I can read it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. It says chocolate chunk.
Awesome. Thank you so very much.
You're welcome.
And thanks for volunteering. This is wonderful.
Of course. Anytime.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
David Bouchard, a Be My Eyes user, describes his experience.
I use the Be My Eyes app pretty frequently. I use it to get visual information that otherwise wouldn't be available to me, such as a sign, a LED screen.
Senior Technical Advisor Chitra speaks from the Microsoft Disability Answer Desk Center.
At Microsoft Disability Answer Desk, we provide free technical support for customers with disabilities. With this integration with Be My Eyes, we can help you with tasks like installing Office 365, troubleshooting your internet connection, or even learning about the physical characteristics of your new Surface Book.
The service offers free technical support for people with disabilities.
All the users have to do is go ahead and click on the specialized help, and there is an option for them to contact the Microsoft Disability Answer Desk to help them with any technical issues they have.
Free app for iOS and Android.
Thank you for calling the Microsoft Disability Answer Desk. How can I assist you today?
It really takes away the visual barrier that sometimes exists. Because it's a free service, I'm really pleased that it augments the skills that I have.
We want to make sure we give our best service to our customers when and how they want.
Everyone who's blind and has a smartphone should have it on their phone. I really applaud Microsoft for taking this step.
Karen, was it you that was telling me?
My name is Karen Bridgman. My 41-year-old son, Kevin, was affected about a year ago, and I learned about this app a couple of weeks ago on our Facebook site and signed up. I had my first call last week. There are 1.4 million volunteers and 84,000 people who are blind or have low vision who are looking for help. So there's help available almost all the time and in any language that's needed. As I say, I got my first call last week, or earlier this week, and it was probably the best 90 seconds I've had in a long time. A young woman needed help knowing of the four canned good products she had, which was the cut green beans. It was as simple as that. She held them up in front of her phone while we talked, and she set the green beans then off to the right and knew which of the kidney beans were which brand and what flavor, and that was it. But she needed help, and there wasn't anybody close around to help her, and I could do that. Kevin's talked a little bit about the fatigue of always feeling like you're relying on the people immediately around you to help you with things and what you do when they're not available. But to read a letter or to tell you if a piece of mail is important, to tell you which is the green beans you want for dinner, this is no investment of time and no cost to either the user or the volunteer. So it's available as a smartphone app for Android and iOS both, and as I say, best 90 seconds I'd spent in a long time.
Thank you. So if you take the concept of Be My Eyes, which you just saw, which is done on a volunteer basis, and you imagine it at a professional level, you'll begin to understand a new app called AIRA. AIRA stands for Artificial Intelligence Remote Agent. It's offered on a monthly subscription based on the minutes used and whether you use your smartphone or eyewear with a camera built in. When you sign up for AIRA and contact an agent, you're connected with someone trained to support individuals with vision loss. Your profile is pulled up with information about your preferences. They can see what you see on one screen and have another screen mapping you with GPS. Maria Johnson is going to demo the Aira app for us.
I have Aira already up on my camera on my phone, and I'm going to call an agent right now, and I'm going to ask him to help me, or him or her, help me to actually get to the podium, and then I'll ask him to navigate me back, and I'm going to ask them to actually explain maybe what they see around the room, which is going to be right through my phone.
It's Peter.
Hi, Peter. How are you?
I'm well, thanks. How's it going?
Good, good. I am actually at a meeting, and I am doing a small demo about Aira, and so I would like you to guide me to the podium of this meeting, if you don't mind.
Sure, if you could hold your phone a little more upright and then scan to the right.
You see it?
Okay, I think I do see the podium.
Should be about that direction somewhere.
Because I do see about three rows away from the front.
Yeah, roughly I am.
If you step over to your left a couple seats, there is someone sitting to your left.
Okay. All right.
And then make a right turn.
Okay.
And go ahead forward. The table on the right is jetting a bit.
Okay.
Into your path.
And where do I go now?
And then one that's make a right.
Okay.
And then one moment while I reconnect the video.
Say that again.
Sound output, speaker.
Okay.
Okay, Merv, there might have been a dead spot in that walkway, but if you turn around, I see you are facing all the tables.
Is that the podium?
No, it's the... if you could just turn around, I think there was a little bit of a dead spot there.
Oh, okay.
Now I do see someone waving at you.
There it is.
Behind the podium right now.
There it is. I'm at the podium. So all I was telling them, Peter, was you can describe what through my camera right now. Do you see like one person, or how many people do you see? Like a lot?
One moment, Maria. I'm waiting for the video and audio to catch up. I see actually several people. I want to say 100 people at least are in this room.
Yes. Yay. All right. That's the answer we were
looking
for.
Rows of tables.
Rows of tables. Right. So what I was just telling them, Peter, is that they can download the app and connect to an agent like yourself. And today it's a guest access site at our hotel, so you can use it for free. So I recommend every one of you download the Aira app, and you can use it for till midnight for free. Whether you're sighted or blind, give it a try, and you can connect to someone as nice as Peter anytime. So Peter, can you help me get back to my seat?
Yes. Can you scan over to the right? Okay, you'll want to head in that direction. You can trail the table along the left if you'd like.
Okay.
And in about 5 steps, you'll make a left. The gentleman at the corner table waved at you.
Hey guys. It's my front row.
There will be a table jutting out from the left. Okay. And then take about 10 more steps forward.
Okay.
And you are at your row. Someone is sitting at the end, so you'll want to take a couple steps more forward and then make a left turn around her chair.
Oh, okay, it's forward?
Yes, and pause here, and you can make a left.
Okay, is there an empty seat here?
Yes, it's the third seat down, and someone is pulling the chair out for you.
Okay, and there I go. We made it, Peter. Thank you.
You are welcome.
All right. Thanks, Peter. Sorry about the technical difficulties, but you did great.
No worries.
Appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Yeah, have a good day. Bye.
Thanks. All right. Thanks, Maria. Thanks, Peter. So, again, it's the difference between the Be My Eyes and Aira especially when you're, you know, if you play with it yourself and get a sense of how it works, you have an agent at the other end who's been trained how to communicate with folks with a vision impairment. And it's not designed to, we kind of had them do things that it's not designed to do. I mean, it's designed so that the person uses their own cane skills, their dog. It's less really an orientation and mobility. It's really more just to describe the environment and help people move around, or do a variety of tasks in life. And Maria can share with you some of her experiences. It's a new technology, and Ira is always looking for ways to make the service affordable. They're working towards offering grants so that college students can utilize it at no charge through grants. So if someone's got a college student, it's worth checking Ira's grant program. They were talking the other day about having support from the VA so that veterans, if they have a program going with the VA, they can get support and much of it paid for by the VA. They're working with corporations to help an individual pay for it. They're working to get certain spaces, like today they're making this space free for everyone, but they're working with places like airports and shopping malls to make certain places Ira accessible so that the individual doesn't have to pay for it. So there's things going on. It's getting it's something to keep an eye on and perhaps consider using. Okay, good. Access to transportation services offered by Uber and Lyft are also facilitated by their apps, and those of course can be used to request and pay for a ride. And then actually, if you're an Ira user, they can actually help calling one of those transportation services. One of the unexpected benefits of that integration I've heard about is that some folks have said in the past, Uber and Lyft drivers may have pulled up and seen an individual with a gorgeous guide dog who has every reason to get into the transportation as anyone else, but the driver might see that and drive away. But if your IRA agent has called and they're tracking it with you, they know who that was. And so they've been helpful in training Uber and Lyft to not do that. To learn more about various apps, because obviously apps are a constant changing situation, one resource is this Facebook group. It's called iPhone and iPad Apps for the Blind and Visually Impaired. A good database of apps checked for accessibility is appleviz.com. Moving away from smartphones and apps and onto other relatively new devices, if you have not yet been exposed to smart speakers, let me give you a very brief overview. They provide hands-free, voice-activated access to an electronic personal assistant. Amazon features the Echo Dot, and more. The prices on this slide were as of March of this year, but they frequently go on sale. Google offers the Google Home, Google Home Mini, and Google Max. I think Susie was going to bring her device here. I'm not sure if she did, but she could talk with her. The devices are similar. They have some similarities where they each have wake words. With Amazon, it's Alexa, computer, Echo, or Amazon. You know, with Google, it's Hey Google, Okay Google, Hi Google. So there's some capabilities they each have done somewhat differently. With Amazon, you can shop, but on Amazon, Google, you can shop over third-party stores. Both brands of devices have a variety of features that can be very helpful. You can listen to music, podcasts, audiobooks. It can answer factual questions, check your calendar, make phone calls, tell you the weather forecast, play games, set timers and reminders, make shopping and to-do lists, and connect to smart home devices.
Alexa, what's the temperature?
Right now in Atlanta, it's 64 degrees.
Alexa, stop! Alexa, how do you spell ammunition?
Ammunition is spelled A-M-M-U-N.
Alexa, stop. Alexa, when do the Hawks play?
The Hawks will play tonight at 8 p.m. away against the Thunder.
Alexa, play the hip-hop Pandora station.
Getting your today's R&B and hip-hop hits radio from Pandora.
Alexa, stop. Alexa, how many ounces in a cup?
One cup equals 8 fluid ounces.
Alexa, what does ambivalent mean?
The word ambivalence means mixed feelings or emotions.
Alexa, add water to the shopping list.
I've added water to the shopping list.
Alexa, play some music.
Here's a prime station you might like, Lana Del Rey.
Alexa, set a timer for 15 minutes.
15 minutes, starting now.
Alexa, IKEA lamp on.
Okay.
Alexa, Christmas tree on.
Okay.
Alexa, IKEA lamp 30%.
Okay.
Alexa, lights off.
Again, Facebook groups are a great way to crowdsource information about these devices. Amazon's got a group called Amazon Echo Dot Alexa and Skills for Blind and Partially Sighted. And Google's got a group called Google Home / Home Mini Blind and VI Users. Now let's talk about electronic eyewear. There are a range of options. Some purely present information in an auditory manner, so they work for anyone no matter their vision. Some present a magnified image, so it only works for individuals who have enough vision to see with the eyewear. Here's Orcam MyEye 2, which is purely auditory and mounts on glasses, currently priced about $4,500.
What we've done is we've taught this little computer to recognize any text and immediately analyze and read back to the wearer the text in that image, or to recognize a face and let me know if it's a man or a woman standing in front of me. And if I know that person and I've already memorized their name into the computer, it'll tell me exactly who is in front of me. So we can recognize text, people, products, banknotes, colors, many other things. It just clips on with magnets onto any glasses. All that I need to do is to point.
You may have been wondering why you have...
As you can hear, it's reading back the text on the page. Now, I have it running off the speaker just so that we can hear it, but normally, if I would be using this for myself, it would be speaking to me through this little speaker. The wearability and the discreetness, the discretion of the device has been very, very key to the development of Orcam MyEye. And that's why we've created it as a very sleek, wearable, minimalistic product. We've been selling in the UK for 2 years now. We're actually just now here at 100% Optical launching the new generation of this device, which is this little one. Up until now, it came as a two-piece device, which was with a cable running between. So we've lost the wire, we've become smaller, and this is what we're now launching. It can even tell me the time. Just on the basis of the gesture.
Again, there's a Facebook group that you can join to learn more called Orcam User Space. Here's New Eyes. New Eyes is a lightweight electronic glasses with magnification up to 12x, selling for about $6,000.
And today we're going to be looking at the New Eyes electronic glasses, which are electronic glasses which help somebody who has a visual impairment to see much better. So now I've got the New Eyes glasses on, and we're going to have a look at the main function of these glasses, which is to magnify. And you're able to see on the screen I've set up to the left of me here, what I'm able to see on the video screens on the inside of the glasses. What we're going to do, we're going to look at the magnification capabilities of these glasses. So if I look over here, I can see some shelving, and there's a sign on top of the shelving, and we're going to go ahead and magnify that sign. And now I'm zoomed in and I can see it says Chicago Lighthouse Products. The camera in the bridge of these glasses is able to focus at all distances, and so we can do the same thing if we're looking at something up close. So if I wanted to read this flyer, for example, I could hold this in front of me. And again, we can go ahead and zoom in and we can read that this says technology products in an open house format. So that's fantastic. Now, if we're still having problems when we're reading things up close like this, we have some other options. We're able to change the colors of the text for better contrast. And so at the moment, we're on regular color, which is nice if we want to look at pictures and things. But if we want to, we can also do a high contrast white on black, like so. And we can do a high contrast black on white, both of which are going to give us really good contrast and will help us to read. The new eyes glasses are what we call smart glasses, and this means that they have a computer built into them. And the computer is actually built into the sides of the glasses here and here. These glasses are wireless, so you do not have to have a wire connected to anything when you use them, which gives you a lot of freedom for movement, which is fantastic. There is an optional telescope, which you can connect to the front of the glasses, very easily just clips on there. And this gives you a little bit of extra magnification power if you need it. It will take you from 10x to 12x, so that's really neat. And in order to control the glasses, there's a few different options. There's a remote control that we can use, slides easily over the finger, and allows our thumb easy access to all of the main functions of the glasses here. There is also actually controls on the underside of the glasses themselves, which we can use if we want to. Or we can actually also use speech recognition and control the glasses with our voice, which has definitely got that cool factor to it. So let's go ahead and give that a try. I'm going to put the glasses on here. I'll just turn them on. And again, if you just look into the television on my left here, you'll be able to see what I can see. So we're going to try and magnify this flyer with our voice. Glasses make bigger. Glasses make bigger. Glasses make bigger. Good, and we could see every time we said the command, it zoomed in. Now let's go ahead and change the colors. Glasses change color. Glasses change color. Glasses change color. And again, we saw every time we issued the command, it changed the color for us. So a super cool way of controlling the glasses, and it leaves us completely hands-free, which is really nice.
The eSight eyewear is similar to the new eyes product we just saw. Key differences are that its magnification is greater, up to 24x zoom, and it's much more expensive, about $10,000. Many folks in the LH1 community have tried the product with a range of variability in terms of whether or not it works for them. So it's really important to try it out carefully before purchasing.
All right, so now I've got the headset on, and as you can see here, the headset is positioned over my eyes and is being supported by my head. And over to the left here, I have a tablet, and the image from the eSight glasses is being streamed to the tablet, so you can see what I'm seeing on the video screens inside the headset here. And straight away, I notice that the image is nice and sharp. They've increased the resolution of the screens and the camera, and so everything is HD and very nice. And the range of magnification has also been increased, so now we can go all the way from 1x all the way up to 24x, so a very wide range of magnification. So let's go ahead and look at something and magnify it. I'm going to look at this sign on the back wall of our store here and go ahead and start to magnify that. And the device is actually telling me as I magnify what magnification level I am on.
6.1 times.
Okay, great. So I magnified to around 6x, and I can read here about Linda on the sign on the back wall. So that's fantastic. So now I am going to have a look at how the device fares when we are looking at something up close. So I've got a flyer in my hand here, and the flyer has got a bunch of text on it. So I'm going to go ahead and look at the flyer, and the device should automatically focus, and I'll be able to magnify it and then change the colors for better contrast. So let's give that a go. So let's have a look at our flyer here. And again, on the tablet to the left, the image is being streamed, so you can follow along. All right, so I have my flyer. Let's make it a little larger.
Four times.
So we're on 4x now, and I'm going to go ahead and change the colors of this text. All right, so we've got a very nice black on white there, which looks great. And there's a white on black. I know a lot of people like this color. And I definitely am noticing that the clarity of this is much better than with the previous model of eSight. Let's see what other colors we have. So a nice black on yellow, and a blue on white, and a blue on yellow. And then we're back to regular color. So I can see these are going to be fantastic for reading. Now, one of the features which is unique to eSight in the area of wearable devices is the bioptic tilt, which is a unique tilt system which eSight have. And the idea is that you are able to wear eSight when you're walking around. And so the way that we do this, at the moment, I have the video screen completely down, so it's covering my field of vision. I can see underneath a little bit, but pretty much covering my field of vision. And it wouldn't really be safe to walk like this. However, if we want to walk, we can actually tilt the headset up and we have two positions we can do that in. So one position would be tilted up somewhat like this. It allows me to see quite a lot underneath the electronic part here. So when I'm walking, I've got a good field of view and I can see underneath the electronic part. However, if I did want to look at something, I can still see the video screens when I look upward. And so I could point my head towards something and just look up into the video screens and magnify that image as I needed to. Now, if you're finding that this is limiting your field of view a little bit too much still and you want as open a field as possible, you can now, with the eSight 3, tilt this electronic part all the way up, and now it's completely out of my field of view. So I've got my entire field of vision that I can use for walking around for mobility.
Another option is iris vision. It's much bulkier than the new eyes and eSight options, but it offers a 70-degree field of view, which likely means that it can be helpful to more folks in the LHON community, as it can be effective with less remaining vision than the other options. They've priced it at $2,500, which keeps it within range of what many vocational rehab programs will pay for. Currently, they're offering a 30-day money-back guarantee with no shipping in either direction. There are some flyers in the back of the room for it. And they sent a demonstration unit. And Andy, if you could stand up one more time. Andy has the demonstration unit and is happy to let anyone try out the Iris Vision product. So
what is the Iris Vision? Well, the Iris Vision is this device here. It's built around a Samsung VR, that's virtual reality headset. And you wear it on your head. And in the front of the device, there is a Samsung smartphone. The makers of this device have customized it, so instead of looking in a virtual world, you're going to be looking at the real world, and you'll be able to manipulate what you're seeing through the use of magnification, through the use of different colors, and all of that kind of good stuff. So I put the device on, and to my left there's a tablet, and hopefully you will be able to see what I'm seeing inside here on the screen of the tablet to give you an idea. Now you will see two images on the tablet, one for each eye. However, I only see one complete image. And now we're through to our live video mode. So I can now look around the Lighthouse store, and this is in real time. Okay, so far so good. Now what we can do is go ahead and magnify to whatever size we want to see at. And this is done via a touchpad on the side of the device here. So I'm going to go ahead and start to magnify, and hopefully you will see the images zooming in. Now this image looks really nice. The screens, like I said before, are very large, and the magnification range is also very good. One of the unique things about this device is the magnification takes place within a circular bubble, and I can control the size of that bubble, again using the touchpad. And so to manipulate that bubble, I'm going to swipe up and down on the touchpad, and hopefully you will see that the bubble is getting smaller here, and now the bubble is getting larger. So the cool thing about this is, if I want, I can make that bubble a little bit smaller, and I can magnify things within that bubble. Around the bubble, everything is still normal size, so I get some context of where I am. I can see things normally there. But within the bubble, the magnification is occurring, and that allows me to see things if I want to, you know, zoom in and get a bit more detail. So very, very cool. So the Iris Vision is able to focus at near or at distance, so we can zoom into the distance and see things, and we can also focus on things up close. And that means we're able to do things like watch television, but we can also read. And so I've got something to read here. And to read, we're going to go into the special reading mode. It's going to make the colors inverted, and it's going to go to full screen magnification. So let's give that a try. So I'm going to hold this up in front of me, and it's just focused. And as before, I'm going to press a button on the side here. And now we've gone into this inverted reading mode, which is really cool. So I'm going to go ahead and magnify, and I can see this really well. So we specialize in the following areas of technology. Cell phones, smartphones, and apps, including the new Lucia 100% accessible mobile phone coming spring 2017. So that's really nice. It's a sharp image. It's full screen. It appears really large in front of my eyes. And obviously the reverse contrast can help make things pop and make reading easier. Very cool. One of the great things about this device compared to some of the other headsets on the market is these lenses and hopefully you can make those out, which you look into when you put the headset on. Now, these lenses are magnifying lenses, and so when you're looking at the screen of the device here, it magnifies that screen and, in effect, makes the screen that you're looking at appear very large, much larger than any of the other headsets that we've tried on the market. And that makes it very comfortable to use this device. Okay, so that's some of the basic features of the Iris Vision.
Another wearable item is the Buzz Clip by Immersive.
Buzz Clip uses ultrasound to detect obstacles that may lie directly in one's path. It then notifies the user of these obstacles through intuitive vibrations, allowing the user to safely navigate around any objects that they may encounter. The Buzz Clip offers essential head-level obstacle detection and can be easily attached to many forms of clothing, making it a highly versatile and useful device. The Buzz Clip is chargeable via micro USB and can last up to 10 hours on a single charge. It has two range options, an indoor mode that has a range of 1 meter and an outdoor mode that has a range of 2 meters. Users can toggle between the two ranges using a simple slide switch that is indicated with tactile markings on the sensor arm.
Well, I'm Ryland Vroom. I'm 6 feet 5 inches tall, and I love, absolutely love the Buzz Clip because the cane does not cover head objects. So the Buzz Clip has actually saved my head a lot of pounding.
See any reason why people would not want to give this a try? This is a groundbreaking evolutionary product that's not only going to change the lives of people, but it's going to change the way people think and how people really understand orientational ability from today's day and age and onwards.
You might recognize Mark DeMontis was one of our speakers last year from Canada. Another item I want to be sure you're exposed to is audio description. AMC, Cinemark, and Regal generally offer it in all their theaters, and you can find it at other theaters too. Just call and ask if they support audio description. It's kind of like closed captioning for the hearing impaired, but for those who are vision impaired. They describe actions, characters, scene changes, on-screen text, and other visual content.
Signs on a tall wire fence read, District Boundary, no access beyond this point, and high voltage. Katniss steps through a gap in the wires and heads into the woods beyond. She glances around before reaching into the hollow of a fallen tree. She draws out a wooden bow. From another tree, she plucks out a sheaf of arrows and straps it over her shoulder. Katniss makes her way through thick green vegetation. Bow and arrow at the ready, she walks over a fallen tree suspended over the forest floor. She pauses, her gaze locked on a deer in the distance. Leaning against a tree trunk, she aims the bow and arrow. The deer sniffs the air and moves out of sight.
You can find audio description on some movies and TV shows at home also. Some devices, such as Amazon Fire TV, have accessibility features built in. You can ask Maria how excited she got at one of these trade show conferences we were at when they demoed the VoiceView screen reader feature on her TV that she didn't realize existed. So hopefully this assistive technology update has provided each of you with at least one new idea of something that could make life easier for individuals affected by LHON. And hopefully you'll continue the conversation about assistive technology options over breaks, networking, and more.